not. Live your life trying to be someone you're not, and do not live your life making yourself miserable just to amount to someone else's idealism. You don't want to be following someone that's taking you down a dark road. Let's make it not cool to be stupid. Let's make it cool to be a good person. I'm tired of it being cool to be a fucking murderer or a shooter. This irrelevant being, like, that shit is stupid. Which is the truth, bro, because I wouldn't be who the fuck I was now if I didn't have any. And I'm aware of that. And I've gone through my fair share of destruction and pain in the process to get where I've gotten. And I know that anything is possible. If I'm gonna die or ever be a sacrifice, I want to make sure that my life made at least 5 million kids happy, or they found some sort of answers or resolve in my life, regardless of the negative around my name, because I know my goal in the end, and I know what I want for everyone, and I know what my message is.
Lads! Ski here, and today I am going to tell you about how
XXXTentacion.
So
X is impacted.
Keep X name, keep X living.
XXXTentacion.
Sean's documentary changed my perspective and changed my relationship with how I interact with an artist and their music for forever.
Someone that's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Yeah, suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad and all, yeah. I'm sad and all, yeah.
As you have all clearly seen in the intro of this video, I've been an XXXTentacion, or as less commonly known, Jaseon for a fan, for a long time, ever since I was 16 years old. I'm 20 years old now. So when I found out that this documentary was dropping on the 15th of March 2022, I was ecstatic. I was excited. I was so happy to finally learn more about an artist that gave me so many good memories for his music, that gave me the ability to express myself and to express emotions that I had never really had to deal with before in that period of time of 2017 and 2018 in my life. Now, after watching this beautifully crafted documentary, I came to the unfortunate and sad realization that the artist that made me feel so happy truly hurt and caused serious pain. Pain that for a lot of people is permanently damaging. Pain that, to be very honest, a lot of people would rather not be on this earth than continue to live on with said pain. And yes, there were so many things that I took away from this documentary in terms of how it was made and how it was shot and how it was edited. But truly, the two biggest things that I took away from this documentary was, does listening to somebody's music enable their negative actions? Is it possible to separate an artist's actions from the art that they create? And I guess I lied about saying only two questions, because the third and final question that I had to ask myself was, did I enable a woman beater?
Geneva went to it. Now, you guys should know who Geneva is, especially if you're a fan of XXXTentacion, right?
Apparently, fans weren't too happy to see X's former girlfriend Geneva show up to pay her respects.
Would you guys rather me dead? Like, dead ass. Like, no playing game shit. Like,
Geneva Ayala is still getting hate till this day. It's been 4 years since Jose Onfroy died, and Geneva Ayala is still getting hate for telling the truth.
Good job. Suck my fucking dick. You know what? Rapping isn't a real job. I mean, I swear to God, try me in my fucking face.
For any little reason, bro, like, the nigga would beat my ass, bro.
This is the reason why I question myself and ask, did I enable a woman beater? Because the bigger X got, the more fans he had, and the more fans he had, the more of those fans called Geneva Ayala a liar constantly.
It got so bad that at some point in time, multiple crazed XXX fans started coming to her job to harass her.
Now, I get it if the situation is that she actually lied. If the whole thing was an actual lie, I understand that. I fully get that. And frankly, I didn't even really fully know about this situation when it was happening back in the day. I knew that X was a very aggressive person from his music and from videos you'd see online, but the only time that I personally found out about this quote-unquote alleged situation was after he died. And a lot of people, specifically his fans, are going to be like, oh, but we shouldn't remember him this way, and we shouldn't try to ruin his legacy or ruin his memory by continuously talking about this one situation in his past. However, I feel like it is ruining his legacy by not adding this. You're not being fully real about it, you know? Like, a lot of people want to shove this under the metaphorical rug and say that this never really happened, when it did. In fact, in this documentary, there's a scene where one of Geneva's friends describes how she could hear X legitimately drowning her at some point in time throughout their relationship, you know? So it's not only just Geneva's word against X's, there's, you know, multiple quote-unquote witnesses to the crimes in general. And the fact that this is information that is public in this documentary, as per if this really wasn't true and they really wanted to make sure that X was going to be remembered in a better way, they would have just cut it out. Or they could have just let it be known that Cleo doesn't believe Geneva. Which, by the way, in case you didn't know, Jase's mom believes Geneva. And that was the point in the documentary that I really had to commend the directors and just commend his mom as well for being that honest. I don't think he really truly understand. Imagine the emotional turmoil his mom had to go through to, first of all, lose a child and then have to accept the fact that their child was so messed up that they physically assaulted their girlfriend multiple times. It must be so heartbreaking, to be clear. Genuinely. And I mean, clearly you see that X's death still affects her to this day. Geneva Ayala, in all honesty, has had to go through so much turmoil and trauma because of X's fans. And it truly shows what happens when you have a toxic parasocial relationship with an artist. And it's such a problem. It's a very, very, very serious problem. Should the artist be held accountable for every person that moves mad
because they listen to their music, which then gives some of these people the energy to move mad or potentially cause some serious harm?
No. That's not the case. However, I think the people listening to people's music need to make a very active decision on what they choose to bring into their heart and what kind of music they choose to listen to. And they need to know themselves enough to see the kind of effect that it will have on them.
Now, where it comes to how I see X,
there are some aspects of him that I'm glad that he held himself accountable to some extent, but he never publicly said it was a lie. He never publicly said that he lied. He never publicly admitted to doing that. And that's the problem. And that is the reason why that till this day, the documentary is out and people are saying that she lied. And it truly, truly is a problem in any community, no matter whether it's music, no matter whether it's YouTube, no matter whether it's sports. Just because you like an entertainer or celebrity and you like the content that they bring to your life doesn't mean that you should ignore quite clear and obvious evidence of them not necessarily being the person that you thought they were, or them having an aspect of themselves that you disagree with. You cannot stay blinded from the truth for too long.
Hopefully this young man, XXXTentacion, his legacy will be one where people start to, as young people, value their life more. But I don't want him to be a hero to people, guys. I'm gonna be honest with you. If you're 15 years old right now, because here's the thing I fear, Ebro, 15-year-olds who loved him and now he died will in some ways idolize him. And he was an incredible talent. He should not be anyone's idol.
Now then, the question is whether that this sin can actually be forgiven. The question is whether his fans even have the right to forgive him. And then there is the question and also the reason about why I'm making this video in general. Can I forgive X for what he did? Can I still enjoy his music during that period of time where he was actively being a woman beater? And the answer to that is, I don't think I'm ever going to be able to vibe with those songs as heavy as I used to before when they first came out, because in the back of my head, there's always going to be this thought of, but he was beating the brakes off of this girl while dropping this music. Because at the end of the day, if we're all gonna be honest here, Geneva Ayola is somebody's daughter, somebody's sister, and was potentially somebody's mother. The point is that I would never want my sister, my mom, my close friend, my acquaintance to ever be in a situation like that, no matter what the circumstances are in general. Now, I think the reason why, knowing about this and learning about this truly for the first time while watching this documentary, hurt me so much was because I truly became a fan of X as he was healing and changing and trying to be a better person. Those videos that you'd see on YouTube of him speaking, the first video that you saw in this video right now was a lot of what he would say and a lot of what he would speak. And even Geneva, who said in this documentary that he was changing and that she was able to find a way to forgive him. But the fact that even she was capable of forgiving him and actually did is the reason why I don't judge people that listen to X's music back in the day. I mean, one of my favorite songs of X is Changes. Changes, Sad, Bad Vibes Forever. Just these songs where you literally see the change in the music. And those are the X songs that I still listen to now. The reason being is because those are the songs that the effect that they have on me is positive. However, if somebody comes up to me and asks if I think XXXTentacion was a good person, I think he was getting there. That's my honest opinion. And I think he was slowly but surely realizing the responsibility that he had as an artist, as a human being with an immense amount of influence. And it's till this day unfortunate that he was never really able to fully show the influence that he would have had if he was still here in a positive manner. And he had a massive influence till this day. Some people call XXXTentacion the Tupac of our generation. Some people say that he made music that was truly able to relate to Gen Z. And frankly, to me, at that period of time in 2017 and 2018, like I mentioned earlier, X made me feel like there was somebody out there that understood how I felt. Juice WRLD as well, but it was definitely him. And I've come to terms with the fact that I can never fully say that he was a great person now. I can say he was a complicated person, that had a complicated past that led him to do the actions that he did. And frankly, I'm glad to say that he was on the rise to being a better person and to truly implement the facts that to whom much is given, much is required.
In my situation, they definitely should pay attention to what I am as a person rather than a character. But it is hard to mend these two things together if everything that I portray as an artist is purely art. So it's hard to tell if as a person that anything that is controversial or spoken on about me is remotely even true. You never know who you're fucking with unless you fully dwell into them as a person. So I definitely think it is very, very important to understand who you are fucking with and who you're listening to.